Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, you are very welcome. If you end up liking this video and you get some value from it, please like, comment and subscribe. I will be very grateful for that. If you're a returning subscriber, welcome back. I must be doing something right. So some time ago I made a video on my 3D printer regarding eccentric nuts and the importance of them, of how to adjust them properly. Lots of people over tighten these nuts and they get what are called flat spots. So I'm going to re-edit my 3D printing video, and it does relate to the laser because they all share the same mechanics, i.e. you've got a what they call a V-slot profile with some wheels that run along the V-grooves, and you have at least one or sometimes two eccentric nuts that you need to adjust. And in this video I show you how to adjust them properly and how little you need to move your spanner to get the correct tension on the wheels. So every time I mention 3D printing in this video, just think about laser. It's the same principle. Sit back, relax, enjoy, get yourself a cup of coffee, and by the end of this video you'll have a very smooth running printer, laser even, and your laser will serve you better. And just remember to check in the morning or before you start a session, just slowly move your carriage from side to side and check whether you've got any flat spots. If you have, just de-adjust your eccentric nuts and you'll see in the video the importance of the little black mark. Anyway, that's me signing out for now. Perhaps I'll see you at the end of the video. Hello all and welcome back. So today we're talking about 3D printers and how to adjust these wheels, because they're not all the same. Let's take a look. And if you're suffering from this problem, if you can listen, you can see I'm rocking it this way and now I'm going to tilt it this way. You can hear that's not adjusted properly, and what that will do, that will badly affect your print quality. So when you see on forums people say you need to tighten your eccentric nuts, which one of the three do you have to choose? So on a standard type backplate, this one actually had four. You can see I've taken one off to better represent a standard backplate. You can see two of the wheels have a smooth spacer block here and here, and the one on the bottom has a hexagonal nut, and this is the one you need to very, very slightly adjust. Now I'm going to put on the screen what these nuts look like, because I don't think I'll be able to zoom into this. But you can see here that the hole that the bolt goes through is off center. So when you turn that very gradually, it affects the distance between the face of these wheels and the face of that wheel. And that then makes this, well, it makes all three wheels grip the profile to stop twisting motion. So what I like to do with these nuts, the eccentric nuts, you can see here, I've marked the face here, and that is the face which is telling me when that is looking at me, that has the least resistance on the wheel. So if you're assembling the wheels, you want this to be facing you, so when you then slide the wheels on the track, it goes on easier, and you should be able to push these cartridges or carriages and they should be able to move. And that's a good indication that either it's too loose in this case it is, or you're getting just about right. So what do you need to adjust these? Well, you need a spanner, and they normally come with the printer. So this is a 10 mil spanner, and when you're adjusting these, how can I demonstrate it? I'm going to put this upright here, so let me get this spanner pretty much, I'm going to do it down here. So when you're adjusting these, let me just zoom out a tad. When you're adjusting these, obviously this nut can turn around 180 degrees and then that will be its fullest adjustment, but you don't want to do that because then you'll be squashing the wheels together.
when you're adjusting these nuts, it's a very, very gradual adjustment. So if you can see my spanner, I'm going to adjust the nut as if this was on my printer. There, did you see it? I actually moved that spanner, and I hardly you watch out here, and I'm going to adjust it again. That was too much. I'm going to move it back. It's just gentle. If you're doing this much, that's too much. You want to do little bits at a time because you need to prevent flat wheels. And flat wheels will happen if you rotate this nut too much and the compression on these three wheels on the profile is too much. And what you'll find is you'll probably be able to print fine for that day. And then when your printer's at rest, say overnight, you haven't used it, that tension is on three spots on the wheels, and overnight you'll get what I call flat wheels. So an important point to note, before you start 3D printing the next morning, with the power off, just move your carriages backwards and forwards. You only have to move it that much, and it's impossible to demonstrate on the camera, but if you move it and you get one wheel rotation, so how can I just mark this? If I just mark this here, so one wheel rotation is from here to there. So I've moved it about 50 millimeters, and that gives me one wheel rotation. So every time I start 3D printing, I get all my carriages which have wheels, and all I do is I move it about 100 millimeters one way, 100 millimeters the back way. And you shouldn't feel at the around the 50 meter mark, you shouldn't feel glonk, glonk, glonk. And that's the flat spots that have generated overnight rotating round and ending up back where they were. So if you do suffer from that, you need to release the pressure on your adjusting nut. And again, it's just a little tweak, not even 1 degree at a time. You know, and that's enough. So this at the moment is too loose. You know, I can wiggle that. So without being able to look at the nut, I'm just gonna move it. Now that's much better. And you saw how much I didn't move it, if you like. I can still feel a rocking motion. So I'm rocking it this way at the moment. Look at that spanner. What have I done with that? So look again at, let's get that better in the shot. I'm just going to adjust it. So let me try and get something in line so you can see where I'm adjusting. So that's it, adjustment done. Still a bit of a wiggle. Still a bit of a wiggle. Still a bit of a wiggle. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to check that these bolts are actually secure, because this has just come out of the packet. So this is quite a cheap one I got off Amazon, and you can see it's cheap because these securing nuts, sorry, securing bolts should come through the nuts, but they don't. They finish almost before the nylock state part of the nut, so it's not very good. So I'm just going to check that these non-adjustable wheels are tight. Now you don't have to do it tight, they just got to be firm. So that isn't, I need to probably do it this way. No, let me rest the spanner on the table. So I'm just going to nip this bolt up just a little bit. They were tight, so this one was slightly loose. So I'm going to slide that back on. And that's made the difference. So that one was very slightly loose. And what I'm actually going to do, because this is such a poor detail, if you turn it this way, you can see that the nut, the bolt that comes through here, doesn't protrude past the nylock. So because these are hard to see when they're on your printer, I'm going to get some new, 5mm bolts, and make sure the bolts come through. So that's just a point to note, because I don't want that coming loose. So that, I can't now rock it this way. Now I'm going to try tilting it. That's firm. So I can still push it, and it does move on its own steam, but then stop. Another test I like to do is when it's on the printer, is just feel, I'm holding the carriage, and I can just turn the wheel without the carriage being pulled out my fingers. And that gives me an indication amongst the three wheels. So that's what I call the slip test. Like here, I can do it easier here. The slip test, I can move the wheels without the carriage being pulled along. And that's given me a good indication that the pressure is enough to keep the carriage from wiggling. I can't wiggle that now, and I can't wiggle it from side to side. But it's not too tight to give me the flat wheel syndrome. It's very important to adjust this nut in very small increments. So when you're moving your spanner, it's like 1 degree at a time, if that. And then check that you can move the carriage. It will have more resistance on your carriages because you would have the drive belt going back to the stepper motor. On here, I've got no drive belt. But yeah, let me know in the comments below if this has helped you. Hey, no one likes tight nuts. And it's important that you don't over tight, because say, when you start printing in the morning, just run your carriages up and down. They should feel smooth. You shouldn't hear after about 50 mil feel a notch. And that's the flat spot that you've generated overnight. And the way to get rid of the flat spot, if it's not too severe, you can just move the carriages backwards and forwards like this for 10 times, and that flat spot will disappear. But then you need to take some tension off your nut. Now, if you've marked it like I did with the marker pen, and I use a hacksaw on mine, so you can just see here, I put hacksaw cut, because eventually this you can see this, the black does wear off, and I know when I see the hacksaw mark, it's at its weakest. So that's it. Yeah, another good video. Hope it helps some of the beginners, because 3D printing, it's not like 2D printing, is it, on a Word document when you print it, and that you just send it to the printer and it prints. There's so many tolerances you have to get right, and if you get this wrong, it can really affect your print. And we all need to start on the same hymn sheet, and it makes your life a lot easier. So that's Andy wishing you a good afternoon and happy printing as ever.
So I hope you found that video of use, especially if you're new to laser engraving. It's one of the vital things to adjust correctly on your laser as you're starting, and it's also important when you do your regular maintenance on your laser, when you check that the smoke protection lens is not fogging up, and you need to clean that with isopropyl alcohol, and when you check your belts, it's good to check your laser carriage. So just slowly move it left to right, and you're just feeling for that bump every sort of 50 millimeters or 2 inches if you're in America and you're using feet and inches. So that's it, another video wrapped up. Please like, subscribe and comment, and if you've got any ideas for videos that you would like to be made, drop a comment below and I'll see whether I can fit that into my schedule. You never know. And if you recommend that video, I'll give you a comment during that video to say, yeah, that was a good suggestion. It is a community here. I do love two-way communication. So if you drop a comment, they are answered. And I try to do it as quickly as possible. But remember, like you, I go to sleep as well. So that's Andy as ever. Continue to make some happy smoke. And I hopefully will join you in the next one. Cheers for now. Thank you for making it to the end of my videos. Much appreciated. If you like what I'm doing and I've earned your trust and respect, perhaps you would consider subscribing. If you leave a comment, I will answer them as well. And if you give me a thumbs up, it will put a smile on my face. Perhaps you would like some of the videos popping up now. See you in the next one.